The Philippine Appellate Court denies a petition for legal protection filed by two environmental activists who were allegedly abducted by the military. The court says petitioners Jed Tamano and Junila Castro were not under threat when they were detained in the military camp last September 2023. It adds there's no proof the two received continuing threats after their release. Their lawyer says they will file the appropriate remedy before the court to challenge the court's decision. Castro and Tamano had earlier alleged they were abducted by military forces for their efforts to stand against the reclamation of Manila Bay.
The Philippine Transport Department eyeing a crackdown on jeepneys without franchises. According to Transport Chief Jaime Bautista, the franchise of operators who failed to consolidate within the program's deadline last April were considered revoked. He adds majority of jeepney operators and drivers are supporting the program.
Magsisimula na rin kaming mag-crackdown ng mga walang mga franchise, ano, yung mga nag-expire yung mga franchise. And karamihan dito mga lumang sasakyan talaga eh. Nakikita na natin yung efficiency, no? Because yung mga nag-ooperate ngayon ay mga corporations and cooperatives, they work together, no? So yung kanilang fleet management is working.
In Japan, the coastal city of Kuji has been inundated with floodwaters due to Typhoon Maria. The storm made landfall in the Iwate Prefecture in northeastern Japan Monday. Authorities warned it could bring record-breaking rainfall, landslides, and powerful winds as it moves across the region. The state weather agency said Maria is the first typhoon to hit the Japanese archipelago this year.
The U.S. and South Korea are set to conduct large-scale military drills later this month. The drills, dubbed Ulchi Freedom Shield, will be held over 10 days starting August 19. Both nations said the drills will reflect various realistic threats. The upcoming military exercises are expected to anger Pyongyang, which has long condemned joint drills between the U.S. and South Korea as a rehearsal for invasion.
This UFS exercise will reflect realistic threats across all domains, such as the Democratic People's Republic of Korea's increasing missile threats, GPS jamming, cyber attacks, and lessons learned from recent armed conflicts. Several United Nations Command member states will contribute military personnel to this exercise. The Neutral Nations Supervisory Commission will conduct third-party observation of this exercise, adhering to the responsibilities outlined in the armistice agreement.
A celebration fit for champs awaits Philippine athletes when they arrive back in Manila from Paris. Malacanang says the Philippine delegation will be honored in an evening ceremony led by President Marcos on Tuesday. There, two-time gold medalist Carlos Yulo will receive the Presidential Medal of Merit, while all athletes get presidential citations. President Marcos will also host a dinner reception at the palace. A Heroes Parade follows on Wednesday that would start from the Elio Theater in Pasay all the way to the Rizal Memorial Sports Complex in Manila.
We want it to be Heroes Welcome, and it's very much focused on them and what they've done to honor the nation. I would describe them as simple but meaningful.
The Paris campaign was the Philippines' best ever performance in the Olympics, timed 100 years since it joined the Games. Manila was the top-performing nation from Southeast Asia and finished in a tie with Hong Kong for 37th place in the overall standings. In entertainment, P-pop sensation Beanie takes Vancouver by storm in their first international solo concert. Cecil Doctor tells us more.
It was meant to be in Canada. It was not in the original plan. But I guess the universe brought us here. So the universe starts in Vancouver.
ABS-CBN's entertainment production head Laurenti Jogi was right, as the girl group Beanie filled the Vancouver venue to the rafters on the initial leg of their first international solo concert dubbed Beanieverse.
Nag-exceed yung expectations namin. Sobrang crazy. Parang yung pagod hindi namin na-feel while performing kasi kumukuha din kami ng energy from them.
Nagulat kami na ganun po kalaki yung venue.
True.
Tapos nagulat po ako po nung show na sobrang grabe yung sigaw nila.
Vancouver Bloom sang along with their idols as the 8-member group performed their hit songs.
Iniisip namin baka mamaya wala masyadong makakilala sa amin, pero grateful po kami kasi may mga kababayan, may mga tao po na nakakakilala po sa Bini.
Yung iba, bumiyahe pa din talaga para makanood dito. Sobrang nakakataba po ng puso. Nakaka-happy kasi na-enjoy po nila.
Thank you po, syempre sa Vancouver Blooms, kayo ang top one.
Even in their short visit, Bini left their hearts in Vancouver.
Hopefully, pag bumalik po kami, mas matagal and mas makapag-explore pa po kami kasi I love Vancouver.
I'd like to say I'll come back to Vancouver because I just really fell in love with the place.
I want to live here.
Yes, I want to live here.
Jogi says Bini is attracting the second generation Filipinos abroad through their music. For the nation's girl group, their goal is for their music and talent to reach people worldwide.
Our big dream is really to get to the major festivals globally, from Coachella to the bigger ones, so that mas ma-appreciate din ang ating Filipino talent by an international audience.
Cecile Docto, ABS-CBN News, Vancouver.